Hey, hello people, my name is Rage, and welcome one and all to The Walking Dead, Michonne. Yes, indeed, I am excited to return to the world of Telltale Walking Dead. It has truly been some wonderful experiences that I've shared with you guys. Detective Lee, Ninja Clementine, and now hopefully a veritable badass. I mean, look at her. I mean, seriously, if there is one person that I have utter faith in not making any of the same moronic mistakes and getting eaten, it is her, of course, for she is legend. Granted, I fully expect every single person that she meets to somehow fall over a tiny pebble, roll around, and get eaten, but that's fine. It's really not. They're idiots. I mean, come on. I'm already having moron flashbacks. That's not even a thing, but it's fine.
I can hardly remember them all.
We gotta get into this. Ooh.
Two. Just two that I can never forget.
I'd hate to be that plant. I mean, I'd hate to be a plant in general, because I hate sunlight, because I'm a massive nerd. I mean, what? Alright then.
I'm done with them.
This is going to be so awesome.
But they're not done with me.
That's not creepy at all. Just as I suspected, a door in the woods. It makes perfect sense. Ah, confirmed then. The world of Zombie Apocalypse takes place in the same universe as Monsters, Inc. Amazing new information here in this game. Do I get to use sword on children? Yeah, we do. Well, I guess that's not really technically a child, but still, you know, at least we get to use sword on someone. That is really where it's at. Alright, the actual holy hell! The actual button interactions are a lot more suave, and they feel a lot better to perform in this one. So that's fantastic. Looks like they've really improved in the last few games that they've done that aren't Walking Dead and applied it to this. Oh, I mean, just look at it. Just absolutely look at it. It is so nice to instantly be playing someone who's just so freaking good at just murdering everything, because you've got to have a plan to kill everyone you see. You just do. And there we go. Oh god, just nice. Whisper sweet nothings in that zombie's ear and send him to his eternal grave the second time. Okay. There we go. Easiest part. Well, I mean, you kind of missed the brain there, I'll be honest with you, but that's okay. Do we think the settee is actually in the woods, or is that just kind of the vision bleeding in? I feel like it might be actually in the woods, too, because of the camper van. They might have had that outside. That makes sense. Well, at least we've got dinner sorted. Ooh, that is ridiculous. That is absolutely ridiculous. Like, there has got to be few things that smell worse than roasted zombie. Like, it is rotting, disgusting meat that is also now burnt the hell up and bubbling. Oh, the word bubbling and flesh should just never go together. This is badass, though. It's really cool to get a really real representation of Michonne's psychosis and how she had trouble dealing with just what the zombie world has done to her, and just seeing her deal with all of these well, I guess, turmoil and warring emotions, like the will to survive, but the refusal to accept what has actually happened. It's just awesome, it really is. And I believe that's what we call fatality. You might want to pick up your sword, though. Ooh. Talk about giving someone the boot. Maybe we don't want to go towards the creepy children door. Just saying. I mean, you got to give credit to her. The fact that she can fight that well in the midst of her own delirium is just incredible. Hey. And I assume he's just come out the trailer. And there are a lot more incoming. I don't like where this is going.
Some days I envy the dead.
Well, I mean, obviously we're gonna lower the gun, otherwise this is a very short game! Part of me does want to see what happens if you choose to pull it, though. Nice. Put a gun in my hand. Why did love put a gun in my hand? In my bed, in my head, in my hand. Now this is an awesome Michonne-worthy intro. Now there are a few schools of thought on how to pronounce her name. Mainly, is it Michonne or Michonne? Michonne? Yeah, Michonne or Michonne. They're the two main ones. I think it's Michonne, but the people in the show say that. But then the creator says something else, and it's very confusing. I once knew someone who called her Michonne, and we don't speak to him anymore. We certainly don't speak to him anymore. There we go. In too deep.
Rashid, come in. Over. Vanessa! You there?
Damn it, Vanessa! Ooh. We're on a boat.
Michonne. What are you
Michonne!
Doing?
Yay! I did it right! Awesome!
Couldn't sleep.
Having those nightmares again. You holding up okay? I'll worry about you. You're not the easiest to read.
I honestly don't know.
This stuff you're dealing with, it's not gonna go away overnight.
Pete will remember that. All the classic signs.
If it gets as bad as it did.
I just need to keep busy.
Oak! Oak! Walk! Get down here. Michonne's taking your shift. 2 minutes!
I still haven't heard from Rashid or Vanessa. It's not like those guys to be in a contact for this long. We trade every time I come through, same spot. Everything's just gone. Just doesn't make sense. Their boat is always
empty. You'll find them.
I like how she just keeps cutting people off with it. Normally it waits till they speak to say your choice. But I guess that's very Michonne-like.
Listen. You hear it? You hear it, right? It sounds like a woman's voice. Vanessa, that you?
I don't hear anything, Pete.
She's there. I just gotta find the right frequency.
Pete? Michonne? Again with the shortwave?
I'm not just giving up. This bay was full of boats just a year ago. They went somewhere.
If they left, it was probably for good reason.
Then I want to know why. Hello? Hello? Can you hear me? Hello?
A boat does seem very sensible in a zombie apocalypse.
You heard it that time, right? She said help.
I don't know, Pete. Didn't sound like Vanessa.
But it's someone. She might know what happened here. No, damn it! We're losing the signal. Look. If we don't start caring about the people that are out there, we're no better than the damn walkers.
All we'll find out there is trouble, Pete.
I mean it. What's the point in just surviving?
Not everyone deserves saving.
And what if I felt that way back when I met you? You should understand why I'm doing this.
I just got told!
Not Birdo, not
but I'm trying to very much get into the character of Michonne and not necessarily just do what I would do.
You know
I like to kind of blend the two.
Take over for me, okay? I'm gonna turn the boat around.
Yay! I can't wait to fiddle with a radio! I just love fiddling with a radio. Okay, let's see if we can make this happen. Oh, I can kind of hear it. Come on. I think it might be three. Definitely think it might be three. Oh, I found the right frequency. Hey! Well, there we go.
Who am I talking to?
Interesting.
Anything?
I heard her. Barely.
I knew it.
Maybe I should have asked her where this she was, but I assumed I'd get more than one question.
You want to find more people. You're forgetting what people are like.
What is she doing?
Shit, what the... Oh, bloody hell!
Who's that? Can't see a damn thing!
Everyone okay? Berto! Sadiq!
You guys better get up here!
Well, that seems a terribly bad luck.
I can't see a damn thing!
Berto! Hold the wheel steady. Take in those sails, now! Sadiq!
Well, this is going horribly wrong.
Are you alright?
I wonder if that actually would have taken him out if I'd not reacted
there.
Thanks
for the save.
Jesus! Oh, get the jib under control!
Damn shortwave. You just had to take us in close, right into a fucking rock.
Hey, I've been sailing these waters for years. There aren't any rocks here.
Well, then what the hell was that?
Something else.
You said it yourself. Something's going on around here. This place isn't safe anymore, Pete. Your friends are gone, and whatever scared them off is gonna find us next. I told you this was a bad idea.
You're just being paranoid.
It's not paranoia.
Stop. We need to free the boat. That's our priority.
She's right. All this talk isn't doing anything to get us out of here.
That girl on the shortwave. What if she's part of it?
Guys, pull it together. Oak, Sadiq, get those sails tied down. Once we've checked for damage, we can haul off. Ease our way out. Go on.
Michonne, what exactly did she say?
She said her name was Sam. I couldn't hear much else.
Do I know a Sam? I feel like I should be like, Michonne, oh, Sam! But maybe
see if
not.
You can figure out what we got stuck on.
Just see if we're close to anything. I mean, I need to know what our options are.
I have a feeling it might be like the floating bodies of zombies, but would that do that? I don't really know enough about boats. I mean, as competent and well-versed sailor as I am, I just don't know.
Seems pretty quiet.
Though I have to say, it is a sterling idea to be a boat survival group in zombies, because there's not really much that can stop you, really, is there? I mean, zombies aren't gonna come swimming for you. It's going to be rare that another group of bandit humans is going to start paddling out to you, so I think it's really quite good. Alright, see if we can see anything. Ah, that's a very good clue. Which it turned out to just be like a massive group of sharks who are just like, what's up? No! Zombie sharks! Maybe that's a little bit over the top. I don't know. That's what scared off everyone else. It turns out it's a massive group of zombie sharks. That would be the plot twist of the frickin' century all up in here. Alright.
What's that?
Ah, now the binoculars might very well come in handy. Because I like to do what makes sense in the situation, because since we're desperate to get unstuck because we feel like in danger, I feel like she wouldn't stop to just chat with people. I saw a flashing light there for a second. I feel like someone might be trying to signal us.
Looks like an old ferry.
Could be worth checking out. You know, extra parts, maybe some food.
I swear I saw a blinking light.
These things are ancient. No wonder they broke.
Okay. I guess I'll help our friend.
Maybe gotta bleed the wind out of this sail.
Stand by what I said. Pete isn't cautious enough.
Look, he's just an optimist.
You call it what you like, but we shouldn't be trying to find people. We should be staying the hell away from them. Look where we are. You think this is an accident? Damn wind.
You're saying this is a trap.
People do anything to survive these days. And to get their hands on a boat like this?
I mean, he does make a fair point. It is a fantastic survival tool, so it would make sense to try and steal it, but you gotta have the equipment for the job. I mean, if you want to steal a boat, you don't have a boat, and having a boat is the best way to get to a boat that is at sea. So I would be quite interested in finding out what the hell has actually gone on here. So I assume they're growing their own food.
This should start producing fruit one of these days.
Which is also a good idea, because even if it rains, it basically just waters them.
It's too dark to see much of anything.
Well then, it's a good job I've got a flashlight, isn't it, Michonne? Oh, that looks like something.
There it is.
Hey, Pete. There we go.
Figured out what we're stuck on.
Damn. At least it's not Rashid's boat.
Hey, Michonne. Hope no one's still on that boat. I don't want to die like that. Sorry.
Well then, don't be a little bitch and go help.
I don't want to see this fall apart, you know? I've seen better places than this.
You're not the only one.
I shouldn't let him see me slacking off like this.
All right, so what is the plan?
Yeah, I know. Working on it.
Okay, so apparently I just walked over to him and just sassed him.
Why isn't this fixed yet, Pete? What the hell are you doing?
Find anything?
Saw a ferry. Maroon near the shore.
A ferry? Didn't see a ferry last time I was here. Tiller lever shot. Snapped in two.
The what?
Tiller lever. Connects the wheel to the...
Look, I don't know shit about boats. Just tell me what you need.
Might have what we
do. We have to. Yep, we have to take a trip to the ferry.
Best option.
Oh, sounds wonderful.
Let's get to that ferry. I don't want to be stuck here any longer than we have to be.
Can't argue with that. Maybe we can find some sign of Rashid's group. Let's round up the crew.
There's gonna be a lot of zombies on that ferry. But it looks like we're gonna be pretty well armed.
You wish. You've got work to do.
You didn't answer my question, though.
Christ, here we go again.
Guys.
You three. Catch the boat, pull her out of here, and lay anchor near the shoreline.
Got it.
Don't go anywhere. Stay near the boat and keep her safe.
So where is our samurai sword then? That's the question. Is this before she got it? But didn't she get it from her own house? I'm actually a little bit foggy on the details.
Forget his friends, right? Best get the parts and get back here. Pete!
We'll get what we need and get out. That's the plan.
Good.
Come on.
Unless I happen to see anyone I can save, in which case, fuck you, Oak! Fuck you! Ah, it's a reddish boat. That's a good sign. Don't tell me it's dirty brown. It's red if you believe it's red, okay? You just have to believe hard enough. Okay? You just have to believe hard enough. I can see this going so brilliantly wrong, though. I really can. But the thing is, I have faith in Michonne to kick General Assery. So, he is hoping this is going to be a swimmingly good rescue slash part recovery mission. Well, actually, I take that back completely. If there's one thing we don't want a water-based mission to be, it's swimmingly anything, because that means we're now in the water, and I don't know about you guys, but any aquatic-based boating exercise, if you end up in the water, you have done something wrong. Sorry, I just had to get that rant out of my...
Probably a good sign. Trouble usually isn't quiet.
I suppose that makes you the exception.
Aw, snap! Bitch, what you say? Straight up stabs him.
You know, something's really been bothering me. And I have to ask.
What?
Do you think this looks dumb?
Oh.
I don't know. I don't think any shit about it. Says I look like a pirate. What do you think?
I like the pirate
fuck
look.
Oak, what does he know?
I knew you were all right. I think it ties the look together. Knew I'd get you to loosen up sooner or later. You're always so serious.
Well, we are in a zombie apocalypse.
Sure you.
Don't test your luck now.
You know, when we first brought you on board, never thought you'd decide to stick around. You didn't talk to anybody. I just assumed you'd take off the minute you got your strength back. Well, I keep expecting to wake up and find this dinghy gone, and you with it. But here you are. Haven't got sick of me yet.
What can I say? You're not terrible company.
Though I will probably leave one day, almost certainly, because, you know, the plot needs to progress. Oh, man, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Pete.
I mean, I saw what you were about to do. You haven't had it easy out there. I know you mostly keep it to yourself. I don't want to make you talk about it.
Being out on the water, keeping busy. It helps. If I stop even for a minute, it starts to catch up to me again. When things are quiet, I end up thinking too much.
I know those feels.
You know,
God, it sucks to think too much.
On my own. Like you were. Convinced myself I liked it that way. But after a while, I just...
Hey! Sudden aquatic zombie man! I'm not sure how they even slightly did that, as they have no way of swimming, but that's fine.
I'm
Seriously, it really... Unless it's shallow enough that they're stood up, I guess. In which case, that makes sense. Oh yeah, they're actually just wading. They're just kind of stood up. Okay, in that case, I accept it. That's fair enough. I thought they were genuinely swimming, in which case that makes no sense. Well, we just gotta stab them all as they arrive. It seems like it should be fairly easy to do. There's not that many of them. Well, rip him. Good job, we had a nice little talk there, Pete, and now you're dead. You are very, very dead. That is unfortunate, but, you know, one of us has to die here for dramatic effect, and it sure as hell isn't me, because I'm the main character, bitch! This is freaking cool, though. They have really stepped up on set pieces. I mean, a freaking aquatic zombie brawl in a turned-up boat arena. I mean, that is what we want in our lives. It really is. Ah, that is badass. Hey, never mind. Pete's got it going. Oh, that zombie thinks it can use that boat. That's adorable. How about we turn around and just kill them? I feel like as long as they don't arrive in too big a numbers, you can just take turns stabbing them. But, you know, what do I know? I guess I've not been in a zombie apocalypse.
That was almost us. Guess I should have kept my mouth shut, huh?
Well,
can't believe it. Jeez.
That could have been a lot worse, you know.
Yeah. I know.
Looks like we need to find a replacement boat. Though you'd think a boat would just be able to mow over them. Though I guess a big enough one would. It's just because it was a rowboat being powered by one dude.
Might be someone who can tell us where everyone went. There's no sign of anyone.
Something might have scared them off.
I hope you're right. Maybe they found someplace better. Well, unless we can find another boat, looks like we're stuck here. Looks abandoned.
We'll figure something out.
Glad you're feeling so optimistic.
Hey, says the optimist.
The ladder or the window.
I feel like, ah, it's a crab! Oh, let's eat it! Let's have crab for dinner! Oh, I can't get the crab. That's so sad. I think the ladder is definitely the better option. We don't want to immediately pile into a dark, enclosed room in a probably zombie-infested boat.
Come on.
Seems like an absolutely abhorrent plan. But then again, knowing my luck, going up here just ends up falling through the floor and end up in the same situation, but now slightly dazed. Well, let's go before they catch up. Oh, come on, it's a ladder! We don't need any fake tension all up in here. Alright, grip the ladder. I guess it could be slick with water, I suppose. It is close enough. Don't you dare oh my god. Zombies don't jump! I got you. I got you, dude. I got you. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Off you go. Off you go. There it is. Well, life rafts. Hopefully there's one still there. The Mob Jack! Alright, Crow.
This place was someone's home for a while.
What did you just call me?
Do you think your friends came through here?
It's hard to be sure.
We should look around.
Well, let's see what we can see then.
Nothing but a hunk of old metal.
Well, that sucks. Can we at least take the metal? No? Oh, no, we can. Good. Might come in handy.
Maybe we'll find something down there.
We'll have to go through the cafe to get to the stairs.
You're just looking for Mr. Honeybars.
Always.
Well, let's do it.
Locked.
Let's not do it.
If one of us can get our hand through here, maybe we can unlock it.
Well, nice. That works. I suppose it looks relatively safe. Anything.
Doesn't mean there's nothing there, though.
Totally gonna be a zombie pop out of nowhere. I'm just absolutely convinced here.
One of us has to reach in there to open it. One of us has to do it.
I'll do it.
I have the power of plot armor.
Be careful.
Though, to be fair, I mean, we saw literally nothing. There's no way there'd be casually a zombie under this door. I mean, really. Why is this so tense? I'm reaching for a handle. This shouldn't be as scary as I'm feeling right. Oh. Is that one right there? I feel like it might be.
Need some help, Pete.
Yeah, it's totally a walker lent against the door, isn't it? That's quite funny. Oh, that's totally gonna happen. We're gonna go barreling in, awkwardly fall over and be like, oh, I'm so sorry. I'm just so sorry. Unless he's already dead. That's a lot of blood.
Come on.
That is a lot of blood. Ah, the squelching sound as they mush up the body to get in. I mean, come on now. Oh, that's not what we want.
What happened here?
A massacre from the looks of it.
Oh, God.
These aren't your friends.
No, no.
Still, that's a very important question. Who tied up these people and killed them?
Wonder what happened to them.
Their wrists are zip-tied. They couldn't fight back. Whoever did this made sure they wouldn't come back. These people hadn't turned. They were executed.
Jesus.
Well, that is worrying.
Holy shit.
Don't leave us here! We want to come with you!
Stay here. I'll be back soon.
Molly, when are you coming back?
This photo. These are their kids. Vanessa and Rashid were here. If they left this behind, Michonne, you okay? You've got that look. Same look you had when...
Does it seem like I'm okay?
No, sorry. They wouldn't have left this on purpose. But I gotta hope they're still alive. That they made it off this thing.
Right then, let's have a little sneaky. Let's back up. Oh, I can only go forward. God damn it. I mean, look at this. You don't want to end up going down into a situation like this. Oh, there's even more of them. There is even more dead people. Oh. Oh, God. Put it down. Just put it out of its misery.
If we're going to find anything in this boat, it'll be in here.
Kill it. Just kill it. Just please stab it and end it. Oh. There we go. There we go.
Cut him down.
All right. I did the rope cutting a lot more impressively, but that's fine. Don't worry about it. I'm really concerned as to what we're about to find in this room, though.
The execution of those people was done to that poor man. Who the fuck could have done that? It wasn't war. It wasn't even...
No one else did this to them. They did it to each other. I've seen it before. This world changes the best of us. Sometimes for the worst.
Not like this.
Not like this, man. Not like this.
Hold up. We don't know what's in there.
Well, here we go.
What do you see?
There's a duffel bag. Looks like it's in good shape.
Any sign of people?
Looks quiet, but keep your guard up.
My guard's always up. Thanks.
All right, sassy. Well, that's a pretty good find. This
makes no sense.
I know, but damn. We could really use this stuff.
That's medicine, ammo, food.
Oh my god. Mary Lily's peaches and beans. God, I used to have these 3 times a day. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Drove my mom crazy. Bunch of medicine.
Where'd all this stuff come from?
Cigarettes.
Don't show those to Berto. We finally just got him to quit.
Plenty of ammunition. We should see what else we can find.
Well, it's open 5 days for lunch and dinner, so I mean, I think we've found a pretty good spot here. We just have to come back on Monday and we'll all have plenty of food. I'm pretty sure that's how it works, right? Okay.
Someone had a sweet tooth.
Well, we might as well keep the sweets then. Hell yes! This seems like a very, very good, solid find.
Who said I was gonna share?
Okay. Cash register time. I mean, we may as well take all the money. I mean, I know it's not worth anything, but why the hell not? Jesus.
Money's still here.
No use to anyone now.
Oh, I don't get to actually take it. That's so sad.
You think candy bars are just gonna magically pour out of there?
I was hoping so, yes!
Never hurts to try.
Well, looks like we gotta go through the doorway. Now, this is where I imagine things are gonna go a little bit worse. Oh no, it's locked. Okay, that's alright. I guess that's all right then. We're good. Unless we have to go in the lockers.
All just lying here, waiting for us. Can't just leave it.
Feels like a trap.
Aha! The lockers!
Whoever's in there, come on out.
We may as well at least check if they're alive.
Shit.
Back up.
Maybe I should have stabbed it. Tackle him.
Greg! What's going on?
Easy.
Who the hell are you people?
Who are you?
Look, kid, just
tell me. Now.
I'm Michonne, and that's Pete.
We're just passing through.
Yeah, sure you are. That bag belongs to us. So
she is shaking like a leaf.
Don't be stupid. I don't want to do this. but we need that stuff. So just back up.
We get it, okay?
Some of our stuff is in there. Let us take it and...
Not gonna happen.
Well, now look what you did. Suppose it's a good job I didn't just straight up stab the locker. Because, I mean, we would have just killed him. Though I would have been very surprised if we did manage to get through the... Oh! A Spartan all up in here! Oh, an actual combination. That's fantastic. Look at that. Oh, Michonne takes no prisoners whatsoever. And one more for the road. Look at this. Just unbelievable. Oh, man. How many does it need? Talk about cashing out. I swear to God, if you aim that gun at us again.
Hey!
Stop her!
Let me go!
Oh, crap.
Hey!
I guess they don't know each other then?
Randall! Shit!
How many different groups are there here? Well, I think we've found out who was tying people up and executing them.
You. Man, you gotta be kidding me.
That guy looks so smug.
Interesting.
We're not with her.
What?
We didn't have anything to do with this.
This is a mis-
Oh, that's Sam, the help person.
Not sure I believe you. Damn. I know Sam here didn't do all this.
Get them all onto the boat.
And be careful. These new ones aren't fucking around.
We'll take them to Norma.
Yep.
They try anything. Shoot them.
Well, this has gone to hell very quickly. But then again, did we expect anything different to happen? Even slightly. And I'll tell you what this is, guys. I'll tell you what this is. You know what this is? This is the perfect cliffhanger opportunity. Sorry, I just can't resist. I will see you next time then. I will indeed. And we'll see where all of this leads. I'll probably finish the rest of the game on Thursday. At the very least, the next episode is definitely on Thursday, just 2 days from now. So I will see you then, hopefully. And I will most likely finish the rest of the game, as the chapters tend to be about an hour and 20, which is 2 40-minute episodes. That's pretty good. Yeah, this is awesome so far. I am very impressed and I am loving it. Let me know what you guys thought. Like if you enjoyed this, and I'll see you next time. Oh, good boy.